Hi everybody, welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. It's time for a Lakers update. We have some very sad news. We have had so many injuries and illnesses that the Lakers have just been struggling. We are down a number of players every game for one reason or another, between players being injured and out for multiple games in a row to illnesses that are lasting multiple games in a row. So let's get started on those updates. Let's go. In my last video update, I let you know that Rondo had come back and was playing again from his injury. However, after only 1 week, Rondo was re-injured, had to go back in for surgery again, and he's going to be out for another 4 to 5 weeks. Rondo has missed 22 games so far, and it appears that the games are just going to continue to be missed. If you recall, Rondo was suspended for fighting with Chris Paul toward the beginning of the season. That, coupled with the first surgery and now the second surgery, he has missed so many games his first season playing with the Lakers. The Lakers need him back. He is not only a key player, but he is a leader on this team. We need him to recover and come back. He has been at every game, sitting on the sidelines, dressed really nicely, but we need him in playing. Also, since my last video, LeBron has not been back. Like I told you, it was a groin sprain or a groin pull, and he was kind of on a day-to-day basis to determine whether he'd be able to play. He has not been back yet. He has also been on the sidelines dressing snazzy. However, he has not been in the game. It has been made clear that we need LeBron. The Lakers have been struggling to do well to win games without LeBron and his guidance and his leadership. They have really had to fight, and they have won a couple of games, luckily, but some of these players are just exhausted by the end of the game because they're playing longer than they normally would because we have so many people out. McGee is finally back. He has recovered from pneumonia, but it is extremely clear that he is still really, really tired. He can only play for short periods of time. The doctor has only released him to play a little while each game. So because of that, he's pulled out. Chandler has been brought in. We also at least have Zubac that is available to come in and help from time to time, but he's still such a young player and has so much to learn. At the last game, unfortunately, we had two more injuries. Kuzma was taken out of the game and did not return. He had a lower back contusion. He did not return to the game at all. Chandler was injured as well. His back was bothering him. He did return to the game, but you could tell he was moving much slower than normal due to that injury. All of the injuries and illnesses are really, really causing the Lakers to struggle. The Lakers are currently 21-17, which it's amazing that they even have that many wins at this point, because every game has been such a fight, and for some reason at the end they're just so tired because their players have been in for such long periods of time that they cannot pull out a win. Their next game is tonight, Friday, January 4th. They're playing the New York Knicks. The Knicks are currently 9-29. So I'm hoping that because they've been really struggling this year, this will be a little bit easier game for our very, very small Laker team at this point because of so many people being out. It's unknown whether Kuzma will be back for this. It's unknown whether Chandler will be available to play for this game as well. It's unknown whether LeBron will be back. We know for sure that Rondo will not be available for this game. Hopefully JaVale McGee, he will have had a couple more days healing time. Hopefully he can continue playing and won't overdo it and get sick again. This has been a really hard few weeks for these Lakers with this many people out. Luckily, Brandon Ingram was able to come back from his injury and stay in the games. However, he is a young player also. Even though he's very good and very talented, he's so tired by the end of the game that he makes silly mistakes. Turnover after turnover, missed shots. The Lakers will just start to warm up, and when it would possibly be time for another player to come in and give them some relief so that they could continue playing well later in the game, they don't get that relief because there is no one available available to come in and help them. This new Laker team, I mean, they're just learning to play so well together, but with all of the injuries, all of the illnesses, it is impossible for them to have a chance to win every game like they should be doing. If they had every player well and every player without injury at this point, I think that the Lakers would be slaughtering some of these teams. One player though that I do want to talk about that I haven't talked about in the past is Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, also known as KCP. He has become such an amazing player, especially from the three-point line. He also is the best shooter from the free throw line. Kentavious Caldwell-Pope has come in. He makes almost all of his free throw shots and most of his three-pointers. He has been an amazing asset to this team, and he has really stepped up over the last couple of weeks when the Lakers have been shorthanded and short players. He has been playing long periods of time, and he has been doing amazing, making shot after shot, as well as assists. He has been getting rebounds and assisting other players and doing well. Unfortunately, we need a lot of players to recover, come back into the game so that we can start winning more regularly. I hope you enjoyed this update. Unfortunately, the Lakers have been struggling lately because of all of the injured and ill players, but it's been made clear that these Lakers are here to win. When they're all well and playing together, they're gonna be tough to beat, and I am looking forward to that time. I hope you enjoyed this update. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button. Don't forget to subscribe.